this song. So we brought it with the intention of singing it with you. Not to you, because if we all sing it together, as loud as we possibly can, that sort of amplifies the healing power of both. So if we all sing as loud as we can, I promise you, it will reach the person who needs to hear the most. How can we not take that opportunity to do a little bit of good?
Love there is. between us. It's an amazing thing. We decided halfway through this tour that we needed to like build in some moments because people bring out signs with requests. So we got to so we gotta play some new shit. So we're gonna start some new music with one that you may have heard. It's called I Should Have Married You.
Yes.
So tell me all you know about girls. We're far from experts. That's the whole reason we wrote this song. They tell you to write what you know. Here's the thing with the request, guys. First of all, thank you for bringing all these beautiful signs. It's an amazing thing to have that much music that we get to take with us. Here's the real thing. We don't plan on this, so I'm going to ask Andy for a little bit of patience because our crew also doesn't know who we're about to play. They work really hard to make sure our instruments are in tune and that we have the right ones. So be patient while they get us set to play the right song. We also want them to be fine with being such a badass as you want to be. The other thing I would ask is, for maybe a little grace, we don't normally play all these songs, especially ones that we take requests, so here's a good chance. We're all screwing up a little bit. You good? All I know about girls, here we go.
See what you can do here.
some new music. Trevor is not ready. See, this is what happens. You take, you have to remember the songs. He's gonna, sounds like he's tuning.
He's a little tuning.
I think you got it. Here we go.
Oh,
always a reason to celebrate with this band, y'all. Thank you for that.
Thank you!
We've been playing Atlanta since nobody was coming to see us play. We've played every size venue that this town has. But back before that, we moved to Nashville to be songwriters. We weren't even thinking about all this stuff. We were just trying to learn how to write the best song we possibly could. Hopefully make a living at that somehow. After like 10 or 12 years of writing a bunch of, frankly, shitty songs. A couple of good ones. Just got serious.
Yeah.
Feel it?
Yeah.
The room just changed a little. After a while, we actually did have success as songwriters. So, it allowed us to continue to write songs and become this band. What songs are going to connect with the audience, and the truth of the matter is, it's just our best guess. We've learned not to think about that too hard. We just know that we write what we want to hear, and what moves us, and what's on our hearts, and then it's up to you guys to decide if it's any good or not. Yeah. With you. And I say that to say, thank you, because that last song we just played is our most recent number one song. We could not have done it. And so the next song that we're going to play is not much different. It was one that we were second guessing. At least I was. After we wrote it, we wrote this kind of happy, fun, bubbly, cute song that had this like upbeat sort of reggae thing to it. I felt like we already had a bunch of those songs, so I kind of dismissed it. But Brad over here, your boy Brad, thought that maybe we were just hearing it wrong and maybe we should approach it in a different way. So after hearing him express that a number of times, we said, what are you talking about, dude? So he picked up his guitar one night before the show in the dressing room. And he was like, I think we would feel differently about this song if we played it more like this.
Been playing so long for so long. Everybody's singing along.
Yeah.
as you desire. It says, it's a request for my company.
Oh.
time.